Visionary Women is a volunteer-run organization, and I know that every single person who is here is giving their time to one organization or another. And the fact that you have 9 million volunteers, and you were talking about the relationship between volunteerism and willingness, and that it's through willingness that you uplift your consciousness, if I'm quoting you correctly or I'm understanding it. In some ways, talking about how it could be a doorway to becoming a bigger person than mm-hmm. who you are.
See, before we come to women, first thing is visionary. What a vision means is, see, everybody has desires. Desire is an incremental way of enhancing our life. Today you desire, I must have a home, tomorrow you desire, I must have this money, tomorrow you desire something else. These are incremental ways of arranging and rearranging our lives, mm-hmm. which are needed to do a few things. When you say, I'm a visionary, what you're saying is, I have a larger desire, which is not about just incremental improvement of my life. Desire is about me always. Vision is an all-inclusive process. So this itself is a phenomenal thing. If people, instead of having desires, if they have a vision, mm-hmm. vision is always all-inclusive. Desire is personal. Desire leads to incremental changes and improvements. Vision can transform the whole situation. I like music. So, about willingness, because you said you're a volunteer organization, to be a volunteer means somebody who is doing something willingly, right? There's no other compulsion. There are no financial compulsions, there are no social compulsions, there is no something else. You want to do something willingly. So when you're a willing participant, right now, you're a volunteer. I'm asking all of you, right now, are you compelled to be here or are you here voluntarily? Oh, thank you. Because I've spoken to conscripted people also. I've spoken in the prisons, I've spoken in many places. So you're here willingly. You're doing something willingly is the fundamental of your joy, isn't it so? Hello? However simple or stupid or idiotic activity it is, I am doing something willingly makes a world of difference, isn't it so? Hello?
Yes.
The difference between heaven and hell is just this. You're doing something willingly, that's your heaven. You're doing something unwillingly, that's your hell. Hmm? We have already taken on attitudes, what we like and what we don't like. I like this person, I don't like this person. Now with this person I will do things willingly, with this person I'll do things unwillingly. This may be two people, two aspects of life, two communities, two nations, two many things. This I will do willingly, this I do unwillingly. This means I've decided in my mind this is good, this is bad. When I hear even on national news channels, good guys and bad guys, it just, once you have this kind of thing, you are going to be disastrous to the planet. It's just a question of time. The moment you decide, this is a good person, this is a bad person, this has gone deep into American society. No, there are no good people and bad people. Everybody is oscillating between the two. If you create a very pleasant, wonderful atmosphere, everybody behaves wonderfully. If you create an unpleasant atmosphere, a whole lot of people act nasty. Mm-hmm. Yes or no?
Yes.
There are joyful people and miserable people, but there are no good people and bad people.
That's big.
The moment we think we are good, we are entitled to destroy the bad, isn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, we've been destroying a lot of people for a long time. Time to stop that. because human beings are in different levels of experience and understanding, variety of people. Anybody who is not like you is obviously bad, isn't it? Isn't it so? Those who are not like me must be bad people. Because the basis of goodness and what you think is goodness is decided by you. Mm-hmm. No, you have no business to do that. Willing means this, I'm just willing. I'm 100% yes to life. I am not yes to this one, no to this one, no. I'm just yes and yes to life. If you are 100% yes to life, you're a volunteer.
Oh, that's beautiful.
You have become a willing life. You have become so willing that you have no will of your own. People ask me, Sadhguru, how do you operate with all these people? All kinds of horrible questions they're asking, they're doing this, they're doing that. I said, my life is not about them, it's about me. It's about how I am. It's about me. It doesn't matter how they are, that's their choice. But how I am is my choice, this is my way. No matter what they do, I'm like this. Because I have not given that freedom to anybody, that somebody can freak me, somebody can make me angry, somebody can make me happy, somebody can make me unhappy. These privileges I kept to myself. It's time you do that too. Because if somebody else can decide what can happen within you right now, isn't this the ultimate slavery? Huh? Isn't this? Someone else can decide what should happen within you. What happens around you, of course, so many people decide. Hmm? What happens around us is not 100% ours. But what happens within me must be my making, isn't it? Right now, just about anybody can freak anybody because they're not volunteers, they're unwilling. Volunteering means you have no will of your own. You can do whatever is needed. You know, we are a volunteer organization. This means all kinds of people. Most of them are not qualified for the jobs that they're doing. And I cannot fire them because they're volunteers. So people keep coming up to me on a daily basis and say, Sadhguru, I can't work with this person, she's so horrible, I can't do it. I tell them, see, in this world, this is the sort of people who exist, like this, like this, like this, like this, this is the kind of people there are. But if you want to work with ideal people, you must go to heaven. And today. But if you think what you're doing is very significant, you must learn to work with all these horrible people. This is how the world is. If you think what you're doing is very significant, you learn to work with all kinds of people. You will see horrible people will do wonderful things. Yes?
Yes, yes.
But if you want to work with ideal people, you won't find any. I haven't found one yet. All kinds of mixed bags.
Yes.
But if you are willing that you are not yes and no, yes to one, no to another, you're simply one big yes, you will find a way.
Thank you so much. That I